I want to take another question from a viewer of ours. Hussein is calling in from Shillong at this time. Hussein.
Yeah, my question to you is, actually there are a lot of companies like Speak Asia in Assam also. I'm basically from Assam. Mm-hmm. So I can name a few companies like Red Carpet, Shambhav. So they are taking money from, I mean, the hard-earned money from rural people basically, and they're running away. So can these things be done like this? The central government gives some directive to the state government to stop all these companies. Otherwise, okay. Hard-earned money of this.
You made a people. Crucial point, Hussein, and I want to put this question to Pawan Dugal. Mr. Dugal, you began by saying that there is no law to prevent such schemes from flourishing. Do you not think then the law needs to be amended, because this is clearly a new sort of problem that the law needs to account for?
Surely, a couple of things. Number one, the government is not powerless. The question is, whenever the actions or the surveys or the activities of Speak Asia impact computers, computer systems, computer networks, computer resources or communication devices that are physically located in India, the Indian government, the Indian authorities can assume jurisdiction. Number two, I think a preventive action can always be done. There's nothing stopping the government from coming up with an ordinance to prevent any kind of misuse, to prevent any kind of gross violations of law. But most importantly, I think we still have to realize there is no law on protecting consumers online. We have a Consumer Protection Act of 1986, but mind you, not a single consumer forum today entertains an online complaint, because they are pretty much wary about it. They say the IT Act is there. The IT Act is a mother legislation, supersedes anything inconsistent, and continues to be silent. So okay. It's a time for coming up with new legislative provisions in this regard.
But that's something which happens in the future. What happens now, Ms. Dalal? We're seeing the RBI, the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, and the ED are currently probing this. But can they do anything? Do they have the powers to step in and stop this scam, or can nothing be done?
Well, see, first of all, you need an act which bans pyramid marketing schemes, okay? Until then, they're just going to bat around the issue and not come to any conclusions. Let's take it one by one. Ministry of Corporate Affairs says that they're conducting an investigation. Let's start with the first sham. They have collected money saying it's for Speak Asia. The money is going to a company called Speak India, and from Speak India is going through three layers off to Singapore. Now, if they don't get the list of banks and ban that money and stop it from going abroad, 1 week later, the money is all gone. Okay? I know of two banks that have been stopped. Their accounts have been frozen. I don't know of the others. They have accounts in a dozen banks. So if they're going to give them 1 week, it is really 1 week to run away. Look at the enforcement directorate. What is it that they have to investigate? What is this Haran Ventures about? What is the survey software, and what is this pretense? Because there also they've got good legal guys who have told them they are pretending to collect money in the name of a survey. And at the press conference 2 days ago, they came up with something called an e-magazine, e-sign they called it, Survey Today. And that is the agreement signed with Haran Ventures. So where on earth is this e-magazine coming from? Where does it fit into this picture? And tell me one single investor, panelist, consumer, whatever you want to call them, who has been told about this e-magazine which they are supposed to get. In fact, I would challenge them to show me who has got that e-magazine, which they now claim is apparently worth 11,000 rupees. They know that there are some direct selling rules. They get clever lawyers to work around them.